Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for being here and welcome to any newbies that have popped in. I really appreciate you all. Just a reminder to let you know that I am doing personal readings. You can find the information in the description box down below. So this is a pick a card reading. It's a general reading for everybody. So do you know what? Freaking mind went blank there. Right. So what we're doing today, let's start that again, is the person on your mind. So card one, we have the pearl threaded. Then we have card two, which is gifts received. And then we have the seed of the heart. So I'll see you at your piles, guys. Hey, pile one, so if you chose the pearl threaded, this card that you've picked, guys, is you're suffering at the moment, my pile ones, with inner conflict. You're feeling conflicted in this, if you're in a relationship or with the person that's on your mind. So Spirit wants you to know that you need to be a bit patient. You know, maybe you're trying to rush things. Maybe you feel like things are not going the way you want them to go, and it's causing a lot of internal conflict within yourself. You know, maybe you want to get out of this because you feel like you're not getting what you want at the moment. But Spirit is saying just to be patient at the moment and wait. Spirit is saying that there's nothing to actually fix within this connection. So it could be your own insecurities, pile one, that's causing these problems. You know, maybe you've had bad experiences with other connections. It could be that you've maybe like you've gone 100 miles an hour in your past connections, and this person here, this energy here, doesn't want to do that. They want to take their time, and maybe you're just not used to this, pile one, which is actually a really good way to do it. But Spirit wants you to not make any decisions right now until you have clarity in your heart, you know, until your heart tells you when to do it, what to do. You know, your heart, Spirit is saying that your heart will tell you, okay? My pile one. Pile one. So let's get your cards. We have your choice, and this is what Spirit is saying. The choice is yours, but just don't make any rash decisions at the moment, is what Spirit is saying. Let me just see that's in shot. Verge, I'm about to confess my true feelings. Please be willing to listen. There you go. So it could be that this person's like been a bit of a closed book. I'd be very surprised if, you know, the King of Swords or the Queen of Swords comes out, because they're not really emotionally available at times. They don't really wear their heart on their sleeves, if you know what I mean. So you could be dealing with an air sign, Cancer, Scorpio, what am I on about? That's a bloody water sign. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. So yeah, this person's saying to please be patient. They will be confessing their feelings to you. And then we have new perspective. They've gained new perspective and now see they have failed you by their own sabotaging behaviours. Right, so it could be, like I said, that if they're not expressing how they feel and they're taking things so slowly because they're not sure, or you know, they could have been hurt themselves, but that's no excuse. It's caused inner conflict within yourself, pile one. You know, whether you should be hanging around wasting your time with this energy here, which is understandable. And then we have losing battle. You are fighting a losing battle against your opposition. Don't downgrade yourself. Play at your level, not theirs. Right, so this is a bit of a warning from Spirit here. So it could be that this energy, everything's been on their terms, nothing's been on your terms. It's taking it at their pace is what I'm picking up. But you want more. So Spirit is saying don't downgrade. Don't let this person have all their way. Don't let them control the narrative at the end of the day. You need to say how you feel. And that could be where the inner conflict comes from as well, that you feel like that maybe if you were to start opening up and expressing how they make you feel, you may feel like you're going to end up pushing them away. But then this is not really nice behavior from their part, because that's controlling behavior, guys. You know, you should be able to tell them how you feel. And then we have legal issues and family problems. So this energy here could be going through some legal issues. It could even be that maybe they were with a partner before, they could have kids, they could be going through a divorce. For some of you, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. So, you know, they could be going through a hard time, and that could be why they're so wary about jumping in with you, you know, head first, because of what they're going through at the moment. They don't want to repeat that mistake here. And it also could be that they don't want to drag you into their family problems and their legal problems. But sometimes it's good to have a shoulder to lean on, you know. Then we have, I witnessed the darkness and call to the light with my prayer. Thank you, universe, for guiding me to perceive this fear through the eyes of the teacher of love. So this is like, you know, what that card is saying up there. Trust in the universe, trust in yourself as well. You know, you will be guided to make the right decision that's for you, guys, okay? And then we have, I do whatever it takes to get closer to consciousness. Yeah, see, I feel like my part ones, you guys are quite spiritual. You listen to your intuition. You listen to, you know, signs from the universe, if you know what I mean. I do feel like part one, you guys are like that. Okay, let's get your tarot cards, guys. So, Spirit, tell us more about this person on part one's mind. Tell me more about the situation and the person. Tell me more about the person on part one's mind. I will say there are a few, I didn't notice until the other day when I used these cards, like a few, especially the King of Cups, inappropriate pictures, but like I said, my videos are for 18 plus, so, you know, if you don't want to see it, look away. So, Spirit, the person on my power one's mine, thank you. We've got Nine of Pentacles. Hang on, so we've got Nine of Pentacles. Nine of Wands. Tell me about the Nine of Wands. Priestess. So we have the Queen of Cups, Six of Cups, and the Six of Swords. Yeah, look here, guys, with this energy, the person on your mind here, okay, they're going through a lot at the moment with the Nine of Wands. They are quite wounded, and I feel like they've been wounded for whatever they're going through in their life at the moment, like the legal issues, the family problems. Now, this energy has been on their own for a while. They are single, or, you know, maybe not single because obviously they're with you, or it could be that they are single and you're wanting more. It could be that you're just connecting on in different ways, you know, friends with benefits, that kind of thing. But this person is very independent, very successful, but it also can mean success in a connection as well, you know, happiness. Okay, they're doing very well for themselves. You know, there's abundance here, but they are going through a hard time at the moment. They are walking around like the wounded warrior here. But, you know, here we've got the Queen of Cups. See, this is you guys, okay? Water sign, you know, this could be in your chart. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. They see you as the Queen of Wands, whether you're male or female, because these are energies as well, guys. You know, this can be male as well. So yeah, they see you as the Queen of Cups. Now, they see you as someone that is very loving, warm, and kind, okay? And this clarifies what I said about that consciousness there with the High Priestess and the Queen of Cups here. Your intuition is really strong. You guys have the gift, you know, you could be psychic yourselves, you could be into tarot yourselves, but you are someone that has a gift here. Now, so yeah, they see you as someone very loving, you know, and kind and very loyal. And, you know, you guys are an empath as well. So you pick up on their, you know, their energy, that what they're feeling. And they love this about you. You bring them, you know, peace. You bring them happiness. You bring out the silly side of them, you know, like the childish side of them. And, you know, if things are not going the way you want them to go, Spirit is saying that they are nearly there with this. You know, they want to start anew with you. They want a smoother life with you. They want a calm life. They don't want a turbulent life that they've had with whatever they've been going through. And you bring that out in them, you know. You bring out the childish side in them. You know, the fun side that they've been missing for so long here. You know, that's what you do for them. You know, with this High Priestess, you know, listen to your intuition. Your intuition is always spot on, pile one, is what Spirit is saying here. You know, you never really get it wrong. So maybe this time you feel a bit confused because of what's been going on and that, and this is why Spirit is saying, don't make any decisions just yet till, you know, your heart tells you when to make that decision. It could be that this time maybe you're jumping the gun a bit too quickly. Whew. So tell me more about this Nine of Wands. I mean, you know, with the Nine of Coins as well, it could feel like you feel like you're single. You know, that's another scenario that I'm picking up here. It could be that you just feel like you're single, but even though you're in a relationship with this person, or you've got some kind of connection with this person here, and you're always alone because they're off doing whatever they need to do, and you're feeling wounded about this. This is deeply hurting you here, and you've got this cup of love here that you really want to give to this energy here, but they're not seeing it. I'm seeing a lot of conflict here. I'm seeing their energy. I'm seeing your energy here, how they look at you, how you look at them. So, you know, you're actually on opposite sides of the fence here. You've got this love to give them. Look at the bowl that she's holding there. But you feel like you've been neglected or ignored. So it's caused a lot of deep wounds here. But this person sees you, that you bring out the fun side in them. They see, like, you know, a smooth life ahead, basically. Look at this again, guys. The High Priestess just come out again. She's all in and knowing. You're in and... I feel like you do know what you want to do. This is what the High Priestess is here for. You do know. I think you're on the verge of making a decision about this energy here as well. And it could be that because you're not, maybe not being told everything, that you're, you know, or it could be that you're not seeing the bigger picture here. It's like what the first card said here. Tell me about the High Priestess for my pile ones. Yeah, look, you're weighing up what to do here. You're weighing up the pros and cons. It's like decision-making time now, you know. Tell me about the Two of Pentacles. Tell me about... Oh, my goodness. That's too many spirit. Tell me about the Two of Pentacles. Oh. Okay. Nine of Cauldrons. Oh. Okay, got two reversals here. Right. Earth sign here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, we've got here. You know your self-worth, you know that you're valuable, and you feel like if they can't see this up yours, then, you know. You see, like I said, your self-worth, yourself, you know, your own value here. And I just feel like you guys are just like, can you not see who I am? Can you not see the type of person that you've got here? You know, you're blinded to it, basically, is what I'm hearing. And then we've got, well, these upside down. These were upside down, were they not? I swear to God, sometimes I'm a bloody thingy. And I can't rewind the video back. But I did see these as upside down. They were upside down, I think it's the way I put them down. Ignore me. So yeah, the four of... Right, if they're up right this way, the four of cups speaks of feeling rejected. So yeah, you have felt rejected. You've felt ignored, okay? The three of cups is all about celebrations. It's all about celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, weddings. It's a group of people coming together. It's a friendship group. You know, it's harmony here. It's having fun. But then we've got the reversal here. So with the four of cups reversed, I feel like this is going to come to an end, that they're not rejecting you, that they are going to come, because this is, we've got Verge up here, they're on the verge of telling you that they actually want to be with you. So don't act, you know, take a step back is what Spirit's saying. Don't act yet, you know, wait, basically. So yeah, they're not actually rejecting you. But the problem is we've got the Three of Cups in reverse here. This is disharmony. This is a group of people not getting on. It could be a friendship group that where you're arguing with your friends about this. It could be that you feel like you're not being supported by your friendship group here. Maybe they're pressuring you into ending things when you don't want to actually end things right now with this person. I want to clarify this Three of Cups in reverse. I mean, that can also speak of a third party, which would make sense, because if they're dealing with family and they're dealing with legal issues, it could be a third party that's actually involved in this connection, but not romantically involved. It's just the karmic could be interfering with this energy here, and it's causing problems within your connection. So let me have a look at this Three of Cups in reverse. Tell me more about the Three of Cups in reverse. Tell me more about the Queen of Cups. The Three of Cups in reverse. I mean, it could even be a friendship group that's actually telling you that they're using you for, you know, whatever means. Because the Queen of Pentacles, she's very well off. She's very secure within herself. She's financially abundant. You know, you could have your own business here, guys. I'm just going to take that one. Yes, look what I just said. The karmic. This is the karmic wheel. This is the Wheel of Fortune. This is dealing either with karmics or it's karma. And, you know, the wheel's about to turn. Basically, things could be start. Looking up here, hopefully, but I'm picking up more it's the karmic that's involved in this, the karmic that's affecting the connection here. You know, I feel like this energy here is trying to keep the karmic away from you, you know, trying to do whatever it takes to please the karmic so they can get out of this situation here, because look, they feel trapped, they feel stuck, and they can't do anything about it. You know, things are at a standstill at the moment for this connection here. Standstill for this energy here as well. So tell me more about this energy here for pole one. What are their intentions, Spirit? What are their intentions towards my pole ones? What's their intentions? Knight of Wands. Tell me about the Knight of Wands. What I'm seeing here with the Knight of Wands is someone that has no staying power at the moment. They, you know, they come and see you when they can, and then they're gone again. And I feel like this is why you are so conflicted, Pile One, because they've got no staying power. They can't hang around for long. You know, it could just be a sexual thing, like I said, because that is what the Knight of Wands is. This is good. I like this. Their intention towards you has been the Knight of Wands. Someone that, like I said, is in and out, can't stay, can't, you know, hang around for long because they've got other things going on in their life with the karmic, okay? But this is about to change, is what Spirit is saying. Their intentions towards you is, and my light's flickering, so I take that as confirmation. Thank you, Spirit. 401s, this is a twin flame card, guys. So if you believe in twin flame, this could be your twin flame here. This is somebody that wants a proper relationship with you, you know, a serious relationship with you, a serious commitment, and they're serious about this. This is marriage, this is, you know, weddings in the future, it could be births, moving in together. They want the whole thing with you, and they are serious about this. They've had that energy there of the Knight of Wands, which is fire sign Aries, Leo, Sagittarius here, but they're in this energy now. This is what they want. This is why this Verge here is saying, I'm about to confess my true feelings, please be willing to listen. So it could be that you know, you're not really talking to this energy here, and the choice is yours at the end of the day, Part One, you know. But this is what they want. And this is an energy here, air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, that is coming towards you. This is someone that is going to be taking charge, is going to be owning what they want, you know, and they're going to be very direct with you, and they're going to bring about big changes. And this is someone that is going to be quite impulsive, you know, they're going to take a risk with you. I think they're just going to have enough of like holding it back, you know, trying to do the right thing by everybody. Because I feel like they know that they're about to lose you, that you are actually pulling away, Pile One. This is why they're in this panic mode, that they're going to just take the risk. Spirit is saying here their intentions towards you is, you know, to have victory with you, to be successful, you know, to have a successful relationship with you. You know, they want to be with you. So let's get some advice for you guys. Okay, so what advice would you have? My Pile Ones, please, Spirit. Oh. Okay, let's just take it. Nine of Cups again on the back of the deck. Oh, huh. Hello. So, Nine of Cups has come out twice on the back of the deck. I ignored it earlier on. But this is wishes coming true. This is fulfillment. This is, you know, just everything going good for you both here. And Spirit is saying your wish will be granted. You just got to be patient here. The Pentacles, the Ace of Cups, the Mother, which is the Empress, the Knight of Cups. So look here, guys. This person can't let you go. You mean a lot to them, okay? They're holding on to you. They don't want to let you go. And you mean a lot to them. They want you to give them a second chance here, you know, at love. They want a second chance with you. They want to do it right this time with you. You know, this is about, you know, being in a healthy relationship, being in love. It's a connection between two people that have, you know, mutual feelings for one another. This is like a gift from the divine saying, here you go, here's a second chance. But it's whether you want to take it or not. And then you've got the Mother, which is the Empress here. So you are the Empress. They see you as someone that could maybe be the mother or the father of their children. Because don't forget, this is the Divine Feminine. This is an energy here, so you can be male. And they know how lovely you are inside out. We've already got the Queen of Cups there. They see your worth. They see your value. They do actually see it, even though you've been doubting it, pile one, that they, do they actually see who I am? Not meaning that in a horrible way, but, you know, like, hello. I've got all this love to give, but you're not seeing it here. But they do. They see you as the Empress. They see your worth. You've got the Knight of Cups here. Someone that is coming towards you. This is this energy here that will be coming towards you with a message, with some kind of communication to communicate to you their romantic feelings. And this is what they said in that card up there, that they're on their way to communicate to you. And they're going to express their love to you. So I'm going to leave it there, pile one. I hope this resonated. If it did, or if you just liked the video, please hit like. It helps the channel. And you take care, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile two. So if you chose this card, gifts received. Right, with this card, guys, Spirit is actually trying to gift you something here. And maybe you're just not listening. Maybe you don't want to listen. But the universe is actually trying to gift you more abundance, more love, or an answer to something that you've been wanting, wishing, or praying for here, pile two. Spirit wants you to just relax and have a bit of fun. Don't keep worrying about it. Stop obsessing about it, whatever it is that you're, you know, obviously it's a person on your mind. Everything is working out just fine is what Spirit is saying here and what the universe is saying. And the Spirit is saying a nice surprise is coming your way. Okay? So let's look more into that. Let's get your cards. So we have silent moves. I'm making moves in silence. Don't want anyone to ruin my plans. Ugh. Okay. Then we have worried. I'm worried that it might be too late to make things right between us. Then we've got hard to read. You confuse me. You give me mixed signals. Let's put that on there. Then we've got missing you. Their life feels empty without you. They miss you more than words can say, but they think it's too late to fix things. And then we've got coming apart. Meeting you was unexpected. You changed their whole world forever. Feeling lost as they lose their old identity. This is interesting. And then we have someone from your past is coming back. Thanks, Spirit. I love it when it does that. There you go. I didn't even look at these cards. I just shuffled and that was that. So there you go. If this is what you've been really wishing for, this person on your mind, they are actually coming back. Okay. I bet you're sitting there saying, when though? you are going to live a different situation. Oh, interesting, pile two. Hope. Hope is conduit for miracles. There you go. That's what that card said at the beginning. The card that you chose, my pile two, that there is a miracle coming to you. You know, there is a wish being answered, but you're just not seeing it. I choose to learn through love. So yeah, it could be that this energy here, the person on your mind, has learned through this love here, this feelings that they have for you, my pile two. So with the silent moves, we've got someone that is making a move back towards you. This energy is coming towards you because they want to communicate with you about how they feel, but they're not telling anybody. So it could be, you could have mutual friends. It could be, you know, you could know people that they know, but they don't want to tell anyone because they don't want them to ruin it for them. You know, it could be people have interfered in your connection or with this energy here, if you've not had a connection with them. With the hard to read, I find that's your energy here because of what that card from the universe is saying there. It's you're just confused. You don't know whether they want to be with you or whether, you know, you just don't know. I'm feeling confused myself as I'm saying that. So yeah, you are really confused about this person. But they are very worried at the moment that it might be too late. They may have left it too long. They may feel like you've moved on. But I don't see the case. That's the case here. But they are really missing you at the moment. So this could be someone that you've not had any communication for quite a while, is what I'm picking up here, guys. It could be someone that, you know, you may have just had not even a romantic relationship with them, or it could be that things just wasn't the right time between both of you, but you know, this energy is really missing you. But as spirit says with this card here, this person is coming back. They are coming back. And you are going to be living a different situation. So it could be that this relationship or connection with this energy here is going to be so different to what you're used to, that it's going to bring a lot of happiness and abundance, I hope, fingers crossed, for you. But the hope and conduit for miracles here is, you know, there is a miracle about to happen, you know, like a gift, basically. Yeah, you really did blow this person's mind when they met you. You were just someone totally different to who they're used to dealing with here, guys, my pal too. So, yeah, and I think that is what they really like about you. You know, you're someone different. You're not the norm, is what I'm picking up, pal too. Okay, and that's in a really nice way, guys. It's good to be different. So, spirit, tell me more about this energy here, the person on pile two's mind. Tell us more about the situation here. Thank you. Oh, there you go. That just confirms exactly what these cards have been saying. I love it. They've been spying on you. They've actually been checking your social media for quite a while, because they want to know what you're up to. They may want to know whether you're with anybody at the moment. But yeah, they have been doing a lot of spying. Okay. There's also been a lot of gossip in regards to this energy and you guys, pole too. So that could be why they're making the silent moves, like I said, because they don't want people to interfere. They don't want it to get out. And the reason why I laugh with the Knight of Swords, we've got air sign here, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, and we have here as well, is because this person is someone that is just going to take the risk. They're going to come forward. They're coming back. This is someone that takes action. This is an action card here. So it's someone that's going to bring a big change to your life. And they're going to be very direct with you as well. Oh, I like that. Tell us more about Knight of Swords, spirit. More about the Knight of Swords and its energy. Aww. Look at that. The Ten of Cups, guys. Yeah, look, the death on the back of the deck. They're bringing an end to the no contact or no communication. They're putting an end to this. They're done with it being over if you two separated, if you were together, or just no communication here. They see you as the Ten of Cups here. They want this with you. They're coming to bring this big change to you. You know, they want, you know, the change is building a life together, two people making a commitment to one another. Look at the two birds there. Look at the children in the nest. You know, they want children. They want a home life with you. And they see you as their happily ever after. You do something for them. You bring something into their life that has meaning, basically. Tell us more about this Ten of Cups. I'm loving this energy. Look, Knight of Cups, communication is what I've already said. They're going to be coming forward to communicate with you. They're going to express their feelings. But then we have Five of Swords. They tried to stay away from you. They really did try to stay away from you, my pal too. But they just realised that there's no staying away from you. They admit defeat. They know that you're the one for them, you know. They know that you can both have the Ten of Cups together. and they're finally owning this and admitting this to themselves. This is why they're coming forward with communication, the Knight of Cups. Yeah, it's nice. I like it. So, any more here? Any more? You've got to give us a spirit here. Any more about this situation? I couldn't even phrase that right. Do that again, guys. Oh, okay, whatever. Ace of Pentacles, look at that, lovely. We have Judgment and we have Strength. You know, there's been a delay in this happening for you guys, you know, for you, my pole twos. You know, you've waited a while for this to happen. You may need to wait a little bit longer, okay? But yeah, there has been delays in this. But I'm picking up that with this energy here, they're worried about reaching out, communicating with you. Maybe they're worried that you're going to reject them. Maybe they're worried that you're going to be with someone else already. But they're going to find the strength to do this. They are finding that strength to come forward and, you know, reach out to you again. We've got the Ace of Pentacles here. The Ace of Pentacles is an abundant future here with this energy here. It's someone that is secure financially. It's someone that will bring a lot of happiness into your life. It's starting afresh. You know, it could be you both moving. It could be moving in together. It could be getting married. You know, that kind of commitment. You have the King of Cups here. You have the Ace of Cups here, guys. You have the Chariot here. I'm loving this. Oh, you're dealing with an Emperor. Blimey. You know what, guys? I'm going to just send your reading here, to be honest. You've got the Ace of Pentacles, okay? You've got the King of Cups. This is somebody that is loyal. This is a water sign. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, guys. So yeah, this is someone that is very compassionate, very loyal. They're very calm as well. They're calm. They have a calming energy. And this is someone that is in love. This is someone that is, you know, that has a cup of love to give you here. And we've got here, so don't forget, King of Cups can actually be female as well, guys. We've got the Ace of Cups, second chance at love here. They want another chance with you. They want to do right by you this time. And this time they're all in, okay? This time they're going to be all in with you. They know what they want. And this is someone that is coming towards you. This is Chariot. This is forward movement. This is someone that could even be travelling towards you in their vehicle. This is someone that is an action taker, and there's the Knight of Swords up there. They're an action taker as well, and this person's going to be taking, you know, making those moves. So, what advice do you have for my pile two, Spirit? What advice would you give them? Oh my God, no, Spirit. What advice would you give my pile two? Devil, what advice would you give my pile two? Seven of Cups, Queen of Cups. Look, we have a pair here. We have a King and a Queen of Cups here. You guys are a couple. Bear with me, guys. This is your advice from Spirit. Okay, I'm seeing what's going on here. For some of you, it could be that you could be out with multiple people to try and forget this energy here. You know, you could be going out dating other people. And Spirit's advice to you is maybe you need to stop that toxic way about yourselves, my pile two. It could be that Spirit wants you to stop with the control issues as well. It could be that is your problem, that you want to control everything, but you can't control it. It's out of your hands, basically, you know. And it could also be that you're involved with a lot of people here that are no good for you, that don't have your best interest at heart here. You know, they take you down the devil route. The devil route is, you know, drugs, alcohol, sex. You know, it could be that you're having sex with multiple people here and you need to look after yourself because it's becoming a bit toxic, okay? But I do feel like for you, pile two, okay, sensitive subject here, it could be because you're trying to forget this energy here, you know. Maybe you're trying to fill up something, you know, look at these cups, trying to fill up something that's missing. But Spirit wants you to stop doing that because it's becoming quite toxic for your mental health here, which is the Eight of Swords. You're literally putting yourself in a position where it's affecting your mental health here, guys, okay? My pile twos. You know, you are the Queen of Cups here. There's a pair here. You're a couple here. You know, don't lose yourself is what Spirit is saying here. Don't lose who you are. You're someone that is, you know, very loving, very kind. You know, you're an empath yourselves. But I feel like you're losing this about yourself. You know, I feel like a rebellion feeling with these cards, two cards here. It's like, well, you know, I'm like this, but that don't get me nowhere. So I might as well become like the devil, someone different. And Spirit does not want you to lose that about you guys, okay? You know, because it could also damage your connection with this energy when they do come back to tell you how they feel. You know, things could end up becoming toxic between both of you because you've lost yourself along the way, pile two. Okay, so tell me a bit more advice here, Spirit. I don't want to leave it like that for my pile twos. What more advice would you give my pile twos? Just don't let other people, pile two, influence your decision in regards to this energy here, okay? Because I do feel like you're surrounded by people that are really no good for you. Look at this. Look at this, I love this. We've got the Two of Cups, okay? This is a soulmate connection. This is your soulmate, is what the divine is saying. You are, you know, you are in love with this person. This person's in love with you. This is a connection between two people that have mutual feelings for one another, you know? Look at the heart in the middle here. And I feel like this energy here is gonna hopefully balance you back out. You know, you're gonna find your balance, your inner harmony. You know, you're not gonna feel on the wonk anymore because this is what this energy does for you. But Spirit also wants you to find peace within yourself as well, and trust in the divine. When, you know, trust in the universe is what the card said. So I'm going to leave it there, my pile twos. You take care. And if you like this video and it resonated, please hit like. It helps the channel. And I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile three. So if you chose the Seed of the Heart, this is your reading here. So Spirit wants you to know with this card is that you've got a big fear, pile three, of the unknown here. It could be that you're going in a different direction, or a direction that you really don't want with this person on your mind. But Spirit is saying you just got to wait, you know, like a plant. You know, when you water a plant, you've got to wait for it to grow. So you need to be patient and let that grow. And this is what the Seed of the Heart is all about. Spirit wants you to know that something in your relationship is sprouting. You know, it's new energy. It's, you know, it could be a turn for the better. So this person on your mind, you know, just be patient. It could be nothing's moving forward at the moment. It could be like you're at a standstill. But sometimes you've got to wait for things to grow. So it could be just moving at a slow pace to what you're used to. My pile three. So let's get your cards. We have unintentional. I never meant to hurt you. I'm not who you think I am. Then we've got decision. I've made up my mind. I'm not wasting any more time. Love it. Then we have reconciliation. I'm working up the courage to ask you out on the day. Okay. Let's put that on top of that. Then we have old wounds. Their unhealed childhood wounds prevent them from forming meaningful and long-lasting relationships. Okay. Then we have taking aim. They have stepped into their power and taken action towards you. They will not miss their mark this time. Association. Or is that ascension? No, association. Your guides are going to help you to navigate through this situation, right? And that's what the divine has been saying. That's what spirit has been saying. And then we have the moment I realign with love, clear direction is presented to me. And then my outer experiences are a reflection of my internal condition. Right. Okay. This makes a lot of sense. So, my pile three, we have someone that didn't mean to hurt you here, okay? So it could have been that where, you know, with the first card that I read about, you know, things going in a direction that you didn't want it to go in, or it's going in a direction that you're not really sure about where it's going, okay? So it could have been something that they did or said that really hurt your feelings, and you may have, I'm picking up, I feel like the person on your mind, you've separated from them, you've had no communication with them because they hurt you. And I'm picking up it's more of with you, pile three, that they, because they've got these old wounds that they carry around with them and they can't really commit, or they don't want to commit because of fear. It could have been that they've told you this and this really hurt your feelings and you thought, sod it, all right, whatever. But they've made a big mistake here. They're taking aim here because they know that they've effed up, basically. Okay, they want a reconciliation with you. They want to make it right between the pair of you, and they've made this decision, and they want to communicate this with you. Okay, but they are still carrying around old wounds, and hopefully they can heal from these old wounds. And I feel like your spirit guides are, you know, guiding you, helping you with this situation here. And spirit wants you to realign with love here, you know, and then you'll get more clearly. And it could be for this energy as well, that they've finally seen you for who you are, and now they're seeing it more clearly, basically. And the outer experiences, this is the problem, because of their outer experiences, it's affected their connections with other people here. And, you know, it's affected them internally, it's affecting them externally as well. So it's like they need to deal with this. So tell me more about this energy here, spirit, the person on pile three's mind. Tell us about the reconciliation here. Tell me more. Judgment. Yeah, they feel... Okay, this is good. They feel very guilty of what they did to you. They're carrying around a lot of guilty feelings. So fuck knows what they did to you. And they're quite worried about the fact that they've delayed it for so long. So it could be that, like I said, that I feel like you've not communicated with this person, that you've been apart for quite a while. And they're really worried about how you would take it. You know, with this first card, where you know, you saw your future, how you wanted it to be with this person, and it took a different turn, and it's like you wasn't expecting it. But I feel like you've done the right thing here, is what spirit's saying, because, you know, you've literally left them to their own devices, and this seed is literally, you've planted this seed, not intentionally, but you as a person, pile three, you planted the seed in their brain. I was going to say little brain. I shouldn't say that. Maybe they've got a little brain. You planted this seed and the seed is growing, you know? But they are carrying around so much guilt at the moment. You've got the Eight of Pentacles on the back of the deck, and this speaks of someone that is working really hard on themselves. I feel like they're trying to fix themselves here. And let's fingers crossed that they have. So tell me more about the decision card here, please, Spirit. Actually, no. Tell me more about this unintentional. What did they do? I'm being nosy. What did they do, Spirit? Thank God. The wheel. The... Oh. Asshole. Hang on, guys. Tell me about this, lovers. Tell me about the lovers here. I want to know what they did to my path three. Yeah, this clarifies it, basically. Oh, dear. This energy, I'm getting really frustrated, like, not that you can see what I'm doing behind the camera, but it's like I've got my fists clenched here. It's like this energy, but I'm picking up your energy here. It's like you're so frustrated with this energy. Ugh. They've got a lot of karmic debt that needs to be paid off, okay? So this is unintentional what they did to you. They know they hurt you. They decided to let their past hurts, their nine of wands, their past hurts, their past traumas, you know, this is a wounded warrior that's carrying around a lot of wounds here, and they decided to make the decision that you were not right for them, or they didn't want this relationship here, this connection here. This is Gemini energy here, guys. So yeah, they didn't want this connection because of their past, because of the wounds that they are carrying around with them. They cannot let go of these wounds. I'm hoping they are going to let it go, because the Five of Cups is someone that is grieving, you know, grieving for a loss, grieving for what they've lost, or, you know, an ending of a relationship. So they have grief for losing you, but they're also internally grieving for things that have happened to them in the past. And they decided to take this upon themselves and end things. And this is why I feel like there's a lot of guilt in regards to this energy here when they ended things with you. But I feel like the wheel's about to turn here. I feel like the wheel's about to turn in your favour here, guys. Tell me about the... Oh, God. Okay. About the wheel. We've got Death. We've got the Magician. We've got the Hermit. Yes, look here. We've got... Like I said, I feel like the wheel is about to turn here in your favour, because I feel like they are putting an end to their demons and into their problems. They know they're the problem. So they are putting an end to it. Death here. And you've got the Magician. They're using their tools. They're going to use their tools to get, you know, maybe to get back what they want, which is you, you know. Could be that they're trying to manifest you back into their life. Into their life. But I feel like they're mainly using that. This energy here I'm picking up that they've got. They know the right things to say. They know the right things to do to win you back is what I'm seeing here, you know. And they know that they can use these tools not to manipulate you. There's no manipulation here, but to get it what it is that they want here. And also their mask is going to be, the mask that they used to wear with you, they're going to take that mask off, because this person's wearing a mask here. They're going to take this mask off. And they're going to show you their real self here, which is lovely. Finally, I suppose you're saying. You know, they've done a lot of inner reflection here. They've spent a lot of time on their own. They could have maybe even sought some kind of counselling here, you know, to deal with things. But they've done a lot of internal, you know, they've looked deep within themselves at what the problem is here. Got the Ace of Wands, you've got the Four of Wands. This is lovely. they want a passionate beginning with you. You know, they feel very passionate about you. And Spirit's saying you can easily, you know, if that's what you want, you've got a passionate new beginning with them. You've got the Four of Wands, which is the Twin Flame card here. They want marriage with you. They want a serious commitment with you. They may want to move in with you. They want to, you may want to start a family in the future together. But they see you as their twin flame here. I'm going to take those two cards. Tell me about the Four of Wands. Tell me about the Four of Wands and the Ace of Wands, please, Spirit. You know, this is what they think about when they're not with you. This is what they're thinking about now, is what they want with you. Tell me about the Four of Wands and the Ace of Wands, please, Spirit. Thank you. Yeah, look, they know that you, they betrayed you. They know that they did you wrong. They know the way they dealt with things was like the, a big betrayal to you, you know. And I feel like they're hoping you're going to forgive them. But the thing is, they're not very sure how you're going to forgive them, because we've got air sign here, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We've also got Scorpio energy here as well, guys. So with the Queen of Swords, they know you're going to be quite defensive when they do reach out to you. You're going to be on your guard here. You know, you could end up giving them a frosty reception. But this is the Queen of Swords here. She's been deeply wounded. You know, these wounds go really deep. And what this energy did to you, you're still carrying around these wounds. So you are going to feel defensive. You are going to be very wary. But you have the tools to judge the situation correctly for you guys, Pile Three. You know, you're not stupid. The Queen of Swords is definitely not stupid. She can see through bullshit from a mile away, basically. And you're just trying to protect yourself. But you are carrying around a lot of sadness, and they know they did this to you. They, you know, even you feel like you've been betrayed here, the way they did this to you. It could be they could have just buggered off and not told you. You know, that could be another thing that happened. And don't forget, guys, these are energies as well. So the Queen of Swords can be male as well. So if you're female and you're watching this, it can be a male as well, okay? So yeah, you've got a lot of repressed pain, a lot. And so does this energy here. And the repressed pain for this energy here is because of how they did you wrong and losing you and fearing that, you know, have I effed up things with you because of what I did to them. But their heart wants the Four of Wands and they want the Ace of Wands. They want to try again. Oh dear. Tell us a bit more, please, Spirit, from Pile Three. Actually, no, tell me about their intentions, Pile Three. Tell me about their intentions for my Pile Three, please, Spirit. What are their intentions? Ace of Pentacles, look at that. Three of Pentacles, Five of Swords. Right, now I was wondering whether this was going to come out. I didn't say anything, but I was actually wondering it at the beginning, because I said about the repressed pain and the Nine of Wands here, about carrying around deep wounds from the past is what that card said. And then you've got the Hermit here. And I think I did say maybe they're having counseling. So now, Three of Pentacles, I do see this as a collaboration. It's like talking to other people about your problems, you know. And I do feel like maybe they've seek some kind of therapy. I'm not a doctor. This is just what I'm picking up with the cards here. But this is what I feel like they've done. They've literally taken it upon themselves to fix themselves. And, you know, we've got the eye up here. And I feel like, you know, maybe their third eye is open. They've become aware of what they've done, how they've affected their relationships, how they've affected you. And this is really helping them. And, you know, the Five of Swords, this has sort of made them feel quite defeated. You know, they've realised walking away from you was the better option at the time. You know, and you've got to give it to this person. You know, even though it may have hurt you, they know they hurt you, but they had to do it for themselves, and you've got to give it to them for doing this for themselves, because it could have ended up destroying you along the road, you know, if they kept this repressed pain that they've been holding on to for so long. So they had to walk away, they had to leave it behind, you know, leave you behind, because they had to seek the help that they needed. You've got the Ace, their intentions towards you. Look, we've got the King of Swords now, guys. You guys are really like, no, I'm really, really pissed off with this person here. I'm going to have my walls up, you know. But Spirit's saying you've got the Ace of Pentacles here. This is a second chance. Second chance to be with this person, you know, and start again. And they really want a second chance with you to make things right with you. That, you know, you've got a beautiful future ahead of you here. It's abundance, security, financial stability. You know, it could be buying a home. It could be traveling together. You know, they want all these things with you. So hang on. So what advice would you give my pile three? What advice would you give my pile three? Look at this, guys. Ace of Cups. Spirit's advice to you is, you know, everybody has their, you have, you, it's your own choice, but Spirit's saying, give this person a second chance. There is a second chance to make this right. This is the Ace of Cups. It's the second chance at love. It's the second chance at being with someone that you love, you know. On the back of the deck, we've got Eight of Pentacles. This energy here has been working really, really hard on themselves, and they will work really hard to keep this Ace of Pentacles with you, guys, okay? So I'm going to leave it there, my pile three. So that was a lovely reading. All my piles were actually really nice readings today, which is really nice. So if you like this video and it resonated, please hit like, because it helps the channel. And I'll see you soon. Bye.